Hi everyone, glad to see you. This channel is CPro for Swift Programming. We will see how to access shared storage of scoped storage. This guide has 5 parts. Today is the first part, how to read media. Google introduced scoped storage on Android 10. Problem is, unfortunately, we cannot access shared storage directly. Google suggests these 3 solutions. If you want to read shareable media files, Google recommends using the Media Store API. In this sample app, you can learn how to read images and how to show the latest one. Sample app uses Content Resolver class to query media list on Android device. And then, the result list is stored in the cursor container. To use this class and access shareable storage, you need permission to read external storage. To help you understand, I'll write an algorithm using readable pseudo code. Main process is like that. It had 3 steps. First, set up environment to get access permission for shared storage. Second, make data to make image list using Media Store API. The third, process data to show the latest photo from the image list. Let's see each step. First, set up permission. I've omitted a lot of code for simplicity. We'll cover this topic in detail in the next tutorial. Now, the next step, make image list. Using Media Store API is SQL-like. I will explain it so that a person not knowing SQL can understand it. This is a typical SQL select statement. SQL select statement typically has 4 parts. Part 1, from where to get data. Part 2, what data to select. Part 3, conditions that must be matched. Part 4, how to sort selected data. The algorithm of the makeImageList function is like that. Step 1. Prepare 4 kinds of parameters. They are already described earlier at the SQL select statement. Step 2. Fetch data using these parameters. Step 3. While selected data exists, add it to the image list. Let's see each step. To specify from where, you can use external content URI. We'll read ID, name, and date of each media file using Media Store API. If you want to read additional data, you can add it. The third parameter is the matching condition to fetch. You can add a variable using the question mark. Function get days ago is going to be made in a while. Last parameter is sorting order, descending or ascending order can be used. In this sample, we'll use descending order to get the latest image. Parameters done, so let's fetch data using these parameters. Result data will be stored in the cursor container. If the cursor exists, then use it, and finally close the cursor. In the use brackets, if the cursor exists, the cursor is used, and finally automatically closed. In the while loop, if the cursor data exists, then get each data. The result data should be stored in the image list. Image list should be initialized. To get the 1 week ago date, let's make the getDateAgo function. I'll make it into a different file, but the same file is also okay. This is the last main step, show latest photo. MUI has two parts. First part is the read button to read media data. Second part is the image viewer to show the latest image. Now use designed UI components. We'll display file name in text viewer and image in image viewer. To handle the read button, we add the additional step into the main process. This process is for button click. Permission declaration is needed, so read external storage permission is added to the manifest file. Let's summarize this sample app. To read shareable media, direct access is not allowed on Android 10. Google recommends using the Media Store API. The ultimate purpose of using this API is to get the content URI of a media file. Thanks for watching. See you in the next tutorial, how to handle permission.